Hi Facebook, welcome to my new office nook. So I wanted to talk about today something that I went through today, and it is when people like massively hate on your idea. And it's just this feeling that you have where you're like, no, I know this is where we're supposed to be going. I know that we're supposed to go from here to there, and this is a strategy to get there. But what just bothers me to no end is when you have an idea and you want to be innovative and creative, and then like people love to tell you, here are the reasons why this idea doesn't work and you shouldn't even do it. So I had an experience like that today. And it was like, Mercedes, don't even try. Mercedes, you know, it's been done before. Why would we invest in that? And so it's, I get it all the time from different areas, you know, but I wanted to talk about it because it's something that creatives especially go through, and because God has made creatives so different and unique. And I think we're all designed in God's image, and God is a creator God. So he's designed us to be creatives. And I think we're happiest when we're creating. So whether it's music or art or ideas or business strategy, I think when we come up with the innovative solution, I think we're our happiest when we're doing that. And I think we're all designed to do that. So, because it gets boring trading your time for money, right? You want to be creating something. So I had this idea today, and it's just, you know, I had this experience where it was like, no, it's been done before. And it was like a whole room full of people where we're trying to like, you know, brainstorm different ideas. And there's just, it's just really like a big rain cloud on creative energy and problem solving. And I just, this thinking to myself on the drive home, I'm like, you know, I'm sure when the Uber people were pitching that idea, you know, they had the same feedback. Well, we don't need Uber. We already have taxis. Taxis already take care of that. And it's like, well, no, we're going to do it in a different, innovative way to move people from point A to point B. And then, you know, I'm sure when Lyft came out, and they're like, we're going to create Lyft. And they were like, well, we already have taxis and Uber's already out there. I'm like, there's enough market share out there for your idea. So I just wanted to get on and kind of encourage everybody that we have got to be creative, and we've got to be moving towards those things. And we can't let that negativity, and sometimes that negativity is even in our own, like our own head. Our head's telling us that. I don't necessarily have that problem, but when people tell me, Mercedes, we've tried it, it's been done before, it's not going to work, I have this really different reaction than maybe some of you out there. I end up feeling like, but I've never tried it. And so as like, kind of like egotistical as that can sound, I do have a strong history of people telling me, Mercedes, it won't work, don't try it. And then trying it and winning and it working and it making the process better, because you know what? I tweaked it slightly, or I had a different way of approaching it than other people did in the past, or we went with a different company, you know? So when you have those types of ideas, don't let self-doubt and other people's doubt crawl into your headspace and stop you from trying, because it's this fear of failure. And I see it in creatives all the time. Like I've just been assigned to them. God's assigned me to creatives. I'll probably like write a book about all this stuff. But what I see with creatives is this fear of failure, right? And you almost go, instead of moving forward and advancing in the creativity, they end up refining it and doubting it. And it's just this tragic experience of brilliant ideas, but just all this self-doubt. What if I mess up? What if I fail at it? What if it's not gonna work? What if I look stupid, right? Of all things, what if I look stupid? And so it's that fear that stops people from moving forward. It stops people from jumping off, right? But the thing is with failure is it's our greatest teacher, right? If you've ever read, I think John Maxwell's got that book out called Failing Forward. Wonderful read. If you haven't read it, read it, because it talks about all these really successful people who failed a bazillion times and then found success. And so through failing, they find success. Through failing, they start to refine the idea. So anyways, I just, you know, I don't like to go live unless I feel like I have something to say. And I just was so like irritated by this, because a lot of times like there's a knowing, and if you're an entrepreneur or you're a creative, there's a knowing where you just have this gut feeling of like, I'm supposed to go in this direction. I'm supposed to move. This is supposed to be brought to life. That's the best way I could put it, is that it's like something's been deposited inside of you And like as a woman and having carried a child, it grows inside of you and you know it's called to come forth, right? It's supposed to come forth. And there's like a knowing that you can feel. So my point is, the haters are gonna hate, right? The haters are gonna hate and you just gotta let them hate. But if you can ever control it, right? Get them out of the meeting. Like if they're a part of this meeting, move them out if you have the ability to, right? That's always helpful. And you know, another thing I'd love to talk about sometime is the whole creative process and how people communicate. And so there's a big difference between, and now you see this in different team dynamics, right? I've been on a lot of different teams, I've been in a lot of different meetings. And so you'll see it come up where you have a high creative and it's like a brainstorming time, right? Like we're just thinking about what's possible. Like maybe we should have a conference for couples. And then all of a sudden you got the one person in the meeting that's like, well, what color should the tablecloths be? And you're like, we're not there yet. Like, not sure. And then things start to get sidetracked, right? Because this person's gift over here is that they're a refiner. And their gift is like, all right, let's take this idea and really like bring it to life. So practically speaking, what are we gonna need? And it's like, well, we're not there yet. We're just trying to still figure out if we wanna do a conference for couples or maybe we wanna do a conference for like single people. We're not sure. We just know we wanna do something relational. And so I see it manifest all the time. And there's a big difference between taking an idea and trying to help you bring it to life versus that person in the meeting that's telling you it can't be done, don't do it, don't try it, it's not gonna work. That level of negativity is just suffocating to creativity and to innovation. And all of the things that we have in life would not even exist if that person was always in the meeting. So sometimes you just, if you're in charge of them, you can kind of like tuck them away. And when it's time and you're really clear on what you wanna do, then bring it, you know, to the refiner type of person. But anyways, I lost track of my analogy there because the refiner's really not bad. The person that's bad is this guy over here that's telling us, no, that sucks, don't do it. Totally different attitudes. Now that guy needs to get some buy-in, right? He needs to like either change his mindset. I always feel like get out of the way or I'm running you over. Like that's how determined like my attitude is. And so some of you may feel that way, like you're like that, but I'm like, I mean, you either got to get on the bus and find a seat or you're going to get run over. It's those two options, like one of the two. So anyways, I'm just kind of feeling like I want to run over some people today after kind of being told, no, we shouldn't do this or that isn't going to work or here's why it's not going to work. But I think it is going to work. And so I'm just, you know, excited for it. And I'm excited to see what God is depositing and birthing inside of me and really inside of you. Because, I mean, ladies, let's be honest, there's a lot of the people who follow me and who watch me, even there's some men who are probably watching this, will be edified and encouraged. But, you know, ladies, there's a lot of things we carry that we don't even step up into. And a lot of, it's like, you know, I had a boss one time tell me that, like, I wouldn't be good at doing that job, you know, whatever. It was like, whatever. I don't want to like name names because I love all the people I used to work for. But, you know, he was like, you wouldn't be good at this job. And like, you don't have the personality for it. I just hate stuff like that because I'm like, you don't know me. You know, it's like, I could do this if I wanted to do this. And so it's like, but you'd be surprised like how like those different, we'll just call them word curses, right? That negative talk that people speak over you really like jump into your brain. And it's like kind of rattle around in there. And it stops you from even moving forward because you're wasting so much time just thinking about what Dodo said and not moving forward on what you're called to do and what you're destined to do. So stop letting Dodo speak into your life, right? Don't let those things rattle around in there. Kick them out and like proclaim your own identity over yourself. You know who you are. You know, here's the thing that I do because I get prophetic words from time to time, not like Larry does. Larry gets all the prophetic words. I like occasionally get called out. So we had to deal with that jealousy a long time ago. I just figure Larry needs more reminding than I do. So I take my prophetic words and I write them down and then I turn them into like confessions or I'll meditate on them, you know, of the things that God's called me to do and wants me to do. So that's one part of it. But then also like in the Bible itself, who I am, you know, what my identity is. Like we have to be meditating on those things. And then we have to just, I don't know. It's like, we just got to move past what other people are saying about us. You'd be surprised. It's just like the negative confessions people can have over each other. And I know, like, negative confessions is kind of like a Christian-y thing to say, but it's just like the negative self-talk. It's a form of a curse, you know? It's like, it's more of a curse on a person than sometimes actually cursing at a person. It's to say, you can't, you're not able to, you're not smart enough, whatever it is. And then a lot of you, and this is ladies, you know, a lot of ladies deal with it just in their head of you can't, you're not able to, probably because a long time ago, somebody told you that when you were younger and you believed it, right? There's some part of you, even though you don't believe it, there's some part of you that has agreement with it. So it feels like I've been found out, and that's not true. And so anyways, we've got to move forward. We've got to step out. You've got to go for the thing that you're going after. And if you've got a setback, I was driving home from my mom's this morning, and the church on the side of the road had this great little marquee, and it said, your current setback is your future setup for your comeback. And it was probably made it too wordy, but it was very inspirational for a marquee on the side of the road. And I wanted to share it with you because it's like a lot of us can even feel like we're either in a rut or we're in a setback. And just know, it's like, determine, make the choice to move forward, make the choice to have buy-in in the idea that you have, make the choice to set time aside for it, make the choice to be intentional, and then partner with, hang out with people that see that in you. Don't hang out with the people that are telling you can't, you're not able to. Get new people in your life, you know what I mean? Like, go find people that say yes. Like, I just got off the phone with my friend Diane before I did this broadcast, and I was sharing with her what was said. And she's like, no, it's totally possible. You can do it. And I was like, I feel better. You know, it's just, it's funny, but it's like, we need those friends in our lives that say, I see it in you. I know it's possible. I know you can do it. I have faith in you. I'm here if you need anything. You need people like that in your life that are gonna call destiny out of you, right? The thing that's in you, they're going to call that out, and they're going to speak it over you, and they're going to encourage you to go forward. You know, it's like, you're going to go after that doctorate, go after that doctorate. You want people that are going to tell you that, not people that are going to tell you, you don't have time, you're too busy, it's too expensive, how are you going to pay for it, what are you going to do with it? All that stuff, it's like, throw it out the window. You need people that are going to help you problem solve for it. Those are real friends. You need problem solver friends in your life. And you know what? Be the problem solver friend for somebody else, okay? Like, if somebody's going through something, like, ask God. Like, God, give me wisdom. What's the thing this person really needs to hear right now? I do that all the time. You know, people are like, oh, Mercedes, you're so wise. I'm like, half the time you're talking to me, and I'm like, Lord, what's this person need to hear right now? That's what I'm thinking in my head. I'm like, I mean, people I love. I'm like, Lord, I don't know the answer. Like, and that's a conversation I'm having in my head. God, I don't know the answer, but you know the answer. What do you want to tell this person? And like, Christians are supposed to be getting these downloads from heaven. Like, we're supposed to be his hands and his feet here. A lot of times I think we have the problems we do in the world because Christians aren't saying, Lord, what's your wisdom over this situation? And they're not getting the downloads. Like, we're supposed to be the download. We're supposed to be like, you know, like you're getting your download from your podcast. It's like, God's like the heavenly iTunes, and we're supposed to be downloading whatever the latest solution is from him for today's problem. So anyways, I just wanted to share with you all of that. And I want to encourage you to be the problem solvers. I want to encourage you to step out into whatever God's calling you to do. Stop putting it off and be intentional. And then the last thing is, surround yourself with friends that see destiny in you and that are going to be your problem solver friends, your encouragers, your edifiers, and say, yeah, here's how you can do it. What if you did it this way? What if we did this instead of that? What if we scaled it back a little bit and did a version like this? And then next year we did the big version you're talking about. You need people in your life that are going to help you bring to life that creativity, not tell you why it's not possible. So I hope you all really love this. Please like it. Please share it. I know I don't broadcast as much as like Larry does or some other people do, but I really don't, you know, I only want to share when I really have something to say. And this was on my heart. So anyways, I hope you liked it, and I will talk to you guys later. I'm off to make some steak for Miss Liberty. All right, guys. Bye.